Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Learn Linux TV. In today's video, we're going to check out Netdata, something that I've had a chance to check out recently. In fact, I've already implemented it on all of my production servers, which probably gives you a hint as far as what I think about it. But anyway, we're going to take a full look at Netdata in today's video. It's going to get a full review. But I'm probably getting ahead of myself here. So what is Netdata and why might you want to consider installing it? Well, Netdata is a monitoring solution that provides metrics, graphs, and alerts, enabling you to better keep an eye on your infrastructure. It's easy to install and set up, and is a potential consideration for monitoring servers at work or within your home lab. In this video, I'm going to give you my thoughts on this service to help you decide if it's a good fit for your infrastructure. And I'm going to give it a full review in this video. As always, this will be an unbiased review. There's no other kind on this entire channel, because the policy here at Learn Linux TV is that I'll always give you my honest opinion about whatever I'm reviewing, even if it's something that the vendor might not want you to hear. I'll let you know what I like about Netdata, and I'll also offer some constructive criticism as well. By the end of the video, you'll know whether or not this is a solution that you might want to consider for your infrastructure. Now, before we get into that, I need to take a moment to mention the sponsor for today's video. Actually, there's no sponsor at all. I had you going there for a minute. Actually, let's skip the sponsor thing because this video is not sponsored, and we'll jump right into the review. When it comes to monitoring solutions, there's all kinds of them out there. Classics such as Nagios, more modern solutions such as Zabbix, and also things like Grafana for viewing graphs. Each of these solutions handle monitoring in different ways, but the goal is almost always the same, to help you keep a closer eye on the overall health of your infrastructure. And it's not that you can only choose just one. Some organizations use more than one monitoring solution, something that I'll touch on later. And considering that there's so many monitoring solutions out there, I get asked all the time to review X, Y, or Z. But there's simply not enough time to review everything. But when I implement something on my own network, well, that's easy. I'm becoming familiar with it by installing it on my own servers. And that's exactly what I did with Netdata, so it's time to give it a review. And that brings us to today's video. Currently within my home lab, as well as my external production network, I'm using Nagios as my primary monitoring solution. This has been the case for almost a decade, actually. The thing is, Nagios isn't going to win any beauty contests. I mean, look at it. Its interface literally looks like a GeoCities website from 1997. But to be fair, when it comes to functionality, all the boxes are checked. But when you compare the UI in Nagios against that of Netdata, I feel like Netdata wins hands down. But then again, that's not saying all that much, is it? So we'll need to take a deeper look at Netdata to see if it's as good of a solution as it appears to be. The bigger question is probably whether or not I still plan on using Nagios after implementing Netdata, and I'll touch on that later. Now the thing is, when I first started looking at Netdata, I wasn't even looking for a monitoring solution, I was looking for a graphing solution. What I wanted was a dashboard with graphs on it so I could view negative resource trends and take action before things become a problem. And yeah, Netdata does exactly that, but it's not just a graphing solution, it's a full monitoring solution, something that I was pleasantly surprised to discover. Originally, I was considering Grafana, which is really popular when it comes to homelab use, but the thing is, it's a more involved installation, and it's not that I don't like involved installations. I mean, I literally installed OpenShift on OpenStack, and that was a lot of fun. But the thing is, I wanted a solution to provide me with graphs, and Netdata won hands down because it was so easy to implement, it's down to a single command. And speaking of homelab, easy isn't always a good thing to focus on by itself. There's three main decision points, in my opinion, when it comes to implementing a solution within your homelab. Ask yourself the following questions. Is the solution educational? Is it easy to implement? And is it maintainable? Of course, you don't have to answer yes to all of those in order to consider something for your home lab, but those are good things to consider. For example, maybe you'll implement something in your home lab that you use for work, so that way you could better learn it. But at the same time, not everybody has that use case. But you'll definitely want to know how long it's going to take to implement a solution, as well as what kind of workload might be required in order to maintain that solution. We don't have infinite time, so those are some pretty important things to consider, and it's what I look for personally. So definitely keep those things in mind as we look at Netdata or any other solution on this channel. Now, the thing is, I mentioned that Netdata is more than just a graphing solution, so let's look at more of the features and some of the things that Netdata can do for us if we install it. So Netdata is a monitoring solution, like I mentioned a few times now, and it shows you key metrics, it provides alerts, and it also shows you graphs. With graphs, the appeal is that you can see negative trends. For example, if your hard disk is starting to fill up, a graph will show you that trend so that way you can see the rate of change overall and know exactly when you should take action. Now, monitoring solutions also are able to do the same thing, but the problem is that you have to manually create checks for the things that you want to know about. And that creates a situation where if you don't think of a potential problem ahead of time in order to create a check for it, then you'll find yourself retroactively creating checks for things that have failed in the past. And as time goes on, monitoring solutions such as Nagios become more useful as you add more intelligence to it. Now, Netdata features auto-discovery, which is one of my favorite features. I've created a ton of checks within Nagios in the past, like I've mentioned, and to be honest, it's kind of tedious. I mean, I'm accustomed to the process now, but there comes a point where you're spending more time predicting problems and creating alerts than you would to solve anything. But at the same time, this is also a necessary evil within the industry. When it comes to auto-discovery within Netdata, it profiles the server you install the solution onto and configures itself to monitor key metrics that it finds. For example, if you install MySQL, Netdata will see that and monitor it. If you install Netdata onto a virtualization server, such as Proxmox, it'll give you metrics for your virtual machines. Kubernetes metrics? You bet. Web servers? Absolutely. In fact, Netdata found some things that I didn't even know about beforehand, things that I didn't think to configure Nagios for. It detected problems when it comes to dropped packets, something with my NTP server, so it definitely found some things to complain about that I didn't know ahead of time. Now, going back to the three decision points that I mentioned earlier when it comes to implementing something within your home lab, one of the questions was, is the solution easy to implement? Well, Netdata is definitely very easy to implement. In fact, it's down to a single command. As far as whether or not the solution is maintainable, other than installing it, I didn't have to do anything. So yeah, Netdata checks all the boxes and I'm not even done reviewing it yet. And something that really surprised me about Netdata as I looked into it is that it's completely free. Why does that matter so much? Well, I've been working in IT for a very long time, and what I'm accustomed to is filling out a contact form when I want to check out a monitoring solution, talking to a team of sales reps, and then signing a statement of work for a lot of money. That's generally how it goes. But Netdata is completely free, and I do mean completely free, and that's just awesome. So you can install it on your Linux server and not have to worry about licensing or anything like that. You could install it on 10 servers, 100 servers, tens of thousands of servers, and there's no account that you have to create. You don't have to call anyone. You just install it. It's literally that easy. But what does the process actually look like when it comes to installing it? Well, let's check that out. To install Netdata, all you have to do is run their kickstart script. It's essentially a one-line command that'll get Netdata installed on your Linux server. It'll take care of detecting your distribution, so it figures all of that out for you, and after you install it, it'll be added to your server as a repository, so that way, when there's updates, your package manager can keep it up to date from that point forward. So, I'm sorry to interrupt my own video, but did you know that there's a dedicated community page set up for this channel? Well, there is. You could go to community.learnlinux.tv and chat with other Linux fans. All you have to do is go to that page and sign up for an account, and I'll approve your account within a couple of days. You know, I'm always making content for you guys, so I might be glued to the camera, but if you sign up for an account, I'll approve your account within a few days, and then you could chat with us. So come on in and hang out with other Learn Linux TV fans. I would really appreciate that. And the way that the process plays out is that you'll install Netdata on each of the servers that you want to monitor. Once you do this, there's going to be a port that'll be opened up on your server, port 19999. This port will be publicly available, so it's a really good idea to put it behind a firewall, so that way only you can see it. Unless, of course, the hard drive on your Plex server is getting quite full. In that case, you might want to keep that information on the down low. Anyway, continuing, after you install Netdata on each of your servers, the dashboard on those servers will be completely independent from one another. That means if you want to view the dashboard for your web server, you'll visit that web server at port 19999. If you want to do the same thing on your Kubernetes controller, Then you'll view that server at port 19999. And each of the servers won't have any idea that the other exists because each of the dashboards are completely independent. And considering that each NetData dashboard is completely independent, that can become unruly quite quickly. I mean, if you have 1,000 servers, then you probably have 1,000 tabs open within your browser. Or if you're using NetData with Google Chrome, then you'll probably only have 3 tabs open because that's about as many as you can have open before the out-of-memory killer in Linux shoots it down. What's up with the memory usage on Google Chrome anyway? So there has to be a better way. Well, no, actually there's not. You were probably expecting me to say there was. Actually there is, but I had you going there for a minute, didn't I? So yes, there is a better way, and you're looking at it right now. The cloud version of NetData. NetData Cloud isn't really a separate solution. It's more of a value-add service that's kind of like glue, so to speak, that joins all of your servers together under one dashboard. So if you want to view one dashboard and see all of your servers, then the cloud version is the solution that NetData has come up with for that purpose. With a cloud service, you can see all of the servers that you've joined to your cloud account all in one place. You can separate your nodes into their own groups, which are called war rooms, and you can also create your very own dashboards. Now, like I mentioned earlier, NetData doesn't require an account. You can install it on 10,000 servers and you won't have to have a single conversation. So for those of you that are introverts, then, well, you're going to really love NetData because you could talk to literally nobody and use it all the time. However, the cloud version is the exception to that. With the cloud version, you will need an account. So basically, individual implementations of NetData per server will not require an account, but the cloud offering is where you will need an account. But even with a cloud account, your metrics are never stored on NetData servers. Instead, your servers stream their metrics to the cloud offering, such that the metrics pass through NetData servers, but your data isn't actually stored there. So for those of you that are concerned with privacy, I think that'll make you feel a little bit better. On my end, I implemented NetData using the cloud offering so I could see all of my servers in one place. I'm in a state of transition right now, so the numbers that you're seeing here aren't exactly accurate, but that's only because I'm upgrading the Linux distribution on all of my servers, and that project isn't complete yet, but I just wanted to mention that in case you were curious. Now, earlier, I mentioned that Nagios is my monitoring solution of choice. So, did NetData win? Did that replace Nagios in my infrastructure? Well, actually, no, it didn't. Here's the thing. If you depend on your infrastructure, having only one monitoring solution is not a good idea. I don't care how good the monitoring solution is. Sure, many, if not all, of the monitoring solutions out there will claim to be the only one that you'll ever need, and to be fair, maybe that's true, maybe your favorite solution does do everything. But you need a watcher watching the watcher, so to speak. If you only have one monitoring solution, and that monitoring solution goes down, then you might think your infrastructure is perfect, only to find out that it's not perfect, you just weren't getting any alerts because your Nagios server went down. And yeah, it's happened. A few times. For this reason, as good as NetData happens to be, I won't recommend that you use it as your one and only monitoring solution. It's not that NetData isn't up to the task, quite the contrary actually, it's quite good. But again, having just one monitoring solution is never a good idea. So I'm going to keep Nagios around, but I'm also going to keep NetData around as well. I prefer the way that NetData presents information. I also love the graphs and the way that it spots trends, the auto-discovery feature, the way that it profiles your server to find the baseline and configure itself to know what to alert you about, that auto-discovery and auto-configuration side of NetData is awesome. But who knows, I might replace Nagios at some point in the future, maybe Zabbix, but for right now, I have two monitoring solutions that work well, so I'll keep both. That said, I really do like NetData quite a bit. The auto-discovery feature is amazing, the graphs are awesome, best of all, the solution is free, so what could be better than that? That said, I really do like NetData. It's found a home here at Learn Linux TV, but the thing is, there's always a downside. There's no such thing as a 100% perfect solution, so let's talk about some of the downsides of NetData. The first thing is that several features of NetData are only available within the cloud offering. So don't be surprised if you want to utilize a feature on a per-server installation, just to find out that a cloud account is required to use that feature. Now, all of the basic functionality is present even without cloud, But to make a decision on whether or not to implement Netdata, that comes down to whether or not you're okay with having a cloud account. Given some of the features that exist in the cloud account, I kind of feel like you'll end up there anyway. Now, to be fair though, the cloud account is free. There are paid features coming at some point in the future, but Netdata says that everything you have access to today for free will always be free. Anyway, having some features locked behind the cloud offering might annoy some people, but I think it's fine. I mean, the cloud offering is free, and you can't ask for more than that. Now, the other thing that I'll mention in terms of potential downsides is that you can't self-host the cloud offering. If you could do that, then I think Netdata probably would be the ultimate solution overall. When it comes to enterprise, organizations generally don't mind having another company host a solution, but for homelabbers, we sometimes implement things just because it's fun to do so. And that would be point number three in my three guidelines for homelab that I mentioned earlier. So anyway, if you do want to consider Netdata, just be aware that a cloud account is required for a number of the features, and you can't self-host it. Overall, the result of my checking into Netdata is that it's going to be a part of my infrastructure for the foreseeable future, as I've decided to keep it installed. I don't mind having a cloud account, so I use that too. And it works very well on my infrastructure. All in all, I really like Netdata. It's a great solution, and I highly recommend it. So definitely check it out. And considering that you probably have a virtualization solution installed somewhere, you can install it on a virtual machine if you want to, or even just take a snapshot and install it. So that way, even if you don't like it, you can always roll back. I think Netdata is something that's really good to have on your systems, so long as you have a firewall protecting it from the outside. But that's the only thing that I would do. Other than that, it's a great solution, and I think you should definitely check it out. Either way, let me know what you think of Netdata or anything else Linux-related for that matter in the comments down below. I look forward to reading what you guys have to say. In the meantime, be sure to subscribe to Learn Linux TV for the latest in Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.